leaves down.
Okay, I need to know your plan so I'm on the same
page. I'm gonna move it this way.
Okay.
And go in there. I'm gonna try. I've never tried this before.
Well, we could back it up a little bit right there, and I could just swing this end in there. I don't know if that would tip you over or not.
That might work. That's why I got you here. You're the brains of the crew.
Well, as long as it don't tip the crane over is the main thing.
See that? That bump's right there.
Now we are going to have to put probably, we're going to have to, how are we going to tell if we need a shim under here or not? It's going to be hard to tell.
Yeah. Have to measure it maybe from the mill. Kind of go up with a line down it or something and try to.
Well, it's time to keep it in the center of the wall or something.
Yeah, because we're going to.
Maybe we should roll it over and do more of it like right in this area.
Thank you.
side? Put this against it?
Either one, whichever one looks best. Whichever one looks like it's high. That one looks, probably set it on that one, don't you think? Either one will work, I think. That's not more than 4 inches.
Let's flip it up and put it against this.
Yeah. I'll put that tall one back in.
Okay. Well, guys, that's how you make a 24-foot beam.
On the cheap.
On a saw that only cut 16. 16, 5, 7, somewhere under. All right.
Barely got it out of there. It's pretty good centered up, though.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Help it not warp, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're dead center with the point. The
this end's a little low, but that's just the way the long was.
All right, let me get it off there. Just gotta go ahead and cut my notches and we'll put the beam up. Oh, you want to go fishing?
Yeah, I do.
You want to go fishing and do this?
Yes.
All right.
Thank you.